Hello everyone. There are a few great women writers in Bangladesh as well, like Taslima Nasreen, Monica Ali and Tahmima Anam. Tahmima Anam has written a trilogy which include three novels like The Golden Gate, which is the first volume, the second volume in The Good Muslim, and the third is The Bone of Grace. So I will be discussing ideological conflict in Tahmima Anam's The Good Muslim today. Independence has cruel consequences, and these are brought into focus by Tahmima Anam in her second novel, The Good Muslim, which is a sequel to her previous novel, The Golden Age. The novel, The Good Muslim, tells about the consequence of the aftermath of Bangladesh War of Liberation in 1971. It tells the story about a family which has taken part in the liberation war and how they are adjusting with the outcome of the war. The central figure is Maya, a village doctor, and her brother Sohail, who has completely transformed from a liberal individual to a fanatic. When the war was over, Maya, the protagonist, returned back to home in Dhaka after spending time in the country looking after women's health in remote community. But things have changed in the 7 years since she's been home. Her mother is unwell, and her brother's wife has died. Sohail, her brother, is not taking it well and retreating into his new found religion, which Maya finds out putting. But with familial loyalty wins out, or has Sohail completely turned his back on his sister, mother, and son? The novel set in the aftermath of the conflict is a devastating account of two siblings, Maya and Sohail, negotiating life in a new nation hunted both by the past and by the chilling presentiment of the future. This haunting is felt more keenly by Maya, a doctor returning home after some years away. Difference in view regarding religion brings discontent and hostility in brother-sister relationship, as they are unable to understand and convince each other, and this becomes the central conflict in the novel. Their views, ideology, which are completely contradictory to each other, result in weakening of relationship in the family. This is one of the post-war impact of the Bangladeshi society being highlighted so realistically in the novel by Anam. So The Good Muslim opened the window to the post 1970 era in Bangladesh, which reflected radical religious idealism vis-a-vis the historical resolution. The dichotomy of being born in an essentially Islamic environment with overreaching shadow of pre-1971 revolutionary principle get reflected through the sibling Maya and Sohail. It is here that the question of identity and in an Islamic or a secular comes into question. The post-war era thus asks as to who would be a good Muslim. It is through Maya that much of the metamorphosis of the war and the country and the identity of the people post-war as such is being revealed. Her absence for 7 years working as a doctor in the countryside is just a pose with her presence back to her home. The house Shona appears a different house altogether, which she has left. The strong demeanor that all the three, Rehana, Sohail, and Maya, had held during the war seem to have taken a new identity. Rehana, a concerned mother of the pre-war period, now has left the post-war silence of her son to his fate. Her reaction to Sohail's silence and his becoming a Maulana, the changing of Shona to a Jannat, her grandson Jad's upbringing, cite the post-war effect where in an individual is portrayed a triad of life, triad of struggle. Maya, medical knowledge, her worldliness and her independence as a woman gives her a clear view of the injustice and ignorance around her. She is a strong and liberal woman who helps women victim of rapes and molestation in war. Although Maya is a strong counterpoint to the gender abuse, which is one of the theme of the book, Anam is too realistic to make her blazing, all-saving heroine. One of Maya's more tormenting realization is that there are some perpetrators who abuse not only with impunity, but the full support of society. All this may make The Good Muslim sound heavy, but it isn't. Its clarity, alacrity, and succession of brief, vivid scenes give the character room to breathe. Maya is immediately impressive, but Anam's acuity cuts deepest in her treatment of Sohail. In this young man, nationalism, machismo, conservatism and denial mix to create a tragic archetype. His fervor is a crunch for his trauma, guilt and grief. His certainty built on cheeky foundation. Sohail himself should be a fascinating character, a man who has turned to radical Islam after the war, desperately trying to find some sense of meaning in his life. It is ironic, of course, that it should be his mother who casually hand him a copy of the Quran in the hope he might find a small silver of hope. His eventual rejection of his family in exchange for the word of God is heartbreaking. Anam really runs with the idea that people turn to religion in time of need, and it is nowhere more obvious than here. Sohail is so devastated by the war, so dead inside, there's nothing for him to do but turn to a system of belief he used to mock with his sister. His son is perhaps the most interesting character in the novel. Jaed is young and impressionable, but without a strong parental figure, he has become a wild child. Both his parents are so caught up in living the religious life, it seems as though they have forgotten they have a child that needs to be loved and cared for, not indoctrinated with ridiculous religious values. Maya deemed it her job to educate him properly, but her attempt to do so are constantly rejected by Sohail as well as the woman he surrounds himself with. This ultimate rejection of knowledge is favor of faith by denying your son a proper education. It should be punishable by law. But here it's simple because another symptom of the rift that has formed between these two siblings. Sohail going into silence and not revealing the picture of the war days to Maya render astounding alarm. The sibling of the pre-war and war period has shared a connection that was more familiar, but now things have changed. Sohail and Maya had been revolutionary and had shared the pains of war, but now they seem torn apart. While Maya remains the same, carrying the struggle and victory along, her brother is alienated and detached. The brother-sister relationship also highlights the pain that Sohail carries. The crime he has committed as a revolutionary dances in front of his eyes days and night. The burning of the book, his visits to madrasa, his becoming the huzur, his distance from his people project the guilt that he carries, a sin which he wished to watch with the surahs of the Holy Quran. According to him, the book explained everything and set you free. Religion becomes a savior for Sohail, while Maya exhalates between calling herself a revolutionary believer. The change of post-war are also reflected in the lingua franca of Bangladesh. Bangladeshi who had fought the East Wing, that was Pakistan, on ground of declaring Hindu Urdu as the national language, has incidentally started using Urdu. So the good Muslim is about a national victory that does not feel like a victory, a liberation that is damnation for many people due to some unfortunate reason. Anam is one of the generation of writer with a subcontinental heritage whom themes are politicized and universal. She uses a specific history to identify issues that resonate in place and time far beyond post-independent Bangladesh, and it is this pertinence that make The Good Muslim not just an interesting novel but an important one. The novel has received appreciation worldwide. One of the review, the intensity of Anam's picturization and writing has captured people's heart, and it has been praised worldwide. In the novel, she truly questioned the identity of post-war heroes still caught in the conflict of recognizing themselves as citizens of a country which they had fought for. The Good Muslim is a true graph of the post-war Bangladesh presented before the reader in a realistic but fictional way. The novel was shortlisted for the 2013 DSC Prize for South Asian Literature, and it is appreciated around the world for the theme which Anam has taken. Thank you.